University is a co-educational liberal arts college and conservatory of music with an enrollment of 1,400 students. In Appleton, Wisconsin, a small industrial city of 57,000 on the edge of lake and woods country, Lawrence is located 200 miles north of Chicago and 30 miles south of Green Bay. With one faculty member for each 11 students, students work closely with professors. Classes are small. The average size is 21, and while a few popular introductory courses enroll 50 to 70 students, more than half have enrollments of fewer than 14. Thanks to an exceptionally high endowment per student, Lawrence has attracted a faculty of first rank. 88% hold their PhD or other highest degree in their fields. This large endowment also allows Lawrence an extra measure of quality in building its library collection, in developing its computer capacity and laboratories, and in equipping its art studios, theaters, and conservatory. Lawrence operates on a three-term calendar. Students take three courses in each 10-week term. The only requirements are a two-course freshman program and flexible requirements in a major field. Some students take interdisciplinary concentrations or have the opportunity to design their own majors. Typically, a Lawrence student learns in a variety of ways, from faculty or guest lecturers, in discussion classes, through laboratory or library research, by independent study, and participation in one of 14 off-campus programs offered abroad and in the United States. In designing his own program, the student is assisted by a faculty advisor. Most students benefit as well by informal conversations with other faculty members, whom they have come to know through a class, on a university committee, or over coffee at the union. Living arrangements vary: dormitories, fraternities, and small living units. The Lawrence Community Council, an elected student faculty body, writes the legislation that governs student life. Students are represented on all committees that shape the academic programs. Common sense and a concern for reconciling the needs of individuals and the community in which they live form the basis of the few rules and the simple administrative procedures at Lawrence. But what defines Lawrence best is what students do here.
When you study voice, there's only a limited amount of time that you can practice a day without doing injury to your voice.
So it has to sound vague. Now, ba, and don't hold that.
About an hour a day I practice.
It has to sound, vague. No, it's too dark. Tarmi, then she asks.
Although I'm a music major, I'm interested in studying music from a broad historical approach, particularly since one of my major interests is in the medieval period, and I think that any period as far removed from our own period as the medieval is must be understood from the standpoint of all disciplines, not just from one. So I've taken everything medieval that they have to offer in this place. I found professors here quite amenable to interdisciplinary work. For example, I had one professor in a history course who allowed me to write a musical paper on the Elizabethan madrigal. And for the ideas which he didn't understand, he took it to a music professor to read. As for the performer in me, I found that Lawrence has quite a bit to offer in the way of music both to hear and to perform.
Who's interested in working hard and working for themselves is probably the person who's happiest here. There's the opportunity to mess around and do nothing, and there's the opportunity to work if you want to. The people who mess around and do nothing do exactly that and complain about it after they're done not doing it. If you have something that motivates your being here, you're going to be happy. The concept of the liberal arts, to my mind, is one of the most valuable and important things that I've run into. To become an educated man is my goal, is something that's very important to me and should be very important to an awful lot of people. An educated man has a broader base to make decisions and can do anything better if he's educated in a way that teaches him to think and not just in a way that teaches him to memorize or if he learns openness rather than dogma.
What we're working with is RNA synthesis, specifically in oocytes or frog eggs. We're trying to prove it, or trying to find out if maturation really does make a difference in RNA, which has already been synthesized. It takes up a heck of a lot of time. It's much like an independent study. We do lab work when we want to do it. We have keys to the building. It's very independent. I work with 5 other people, and so it's like a team working together. We all pool our data and hopefully get some significant results. Because most people think that once RNA is made, it's set for life or it's been coded, but we're working with the hypothesis that maybe something does happen to it and maybe the base sequence is changed, which would be a pretty revolutionary idea and pretty exciting if we could prove it.
As a senior with a special interest in American government, I enrolled in the Washington semester program. This program was consisted of a term in Washington and a course of study for about 3.5 months, which included an internship, independent project, and 30 or 40 seminars with government officials from all over Washington. It was really an interesting experience because it allowed me to kind of tie together some of the things I had learned in the course of my political science courses here at Lawrence. Most students take advantage of some off-campus program or other in the course of their 4 years here, whether it be a course of study overseas in France or Spain or Paris or Mexico or of course there's one in urban studies that's held in Chicago.
I originally came here as a Spanish major. I had a large background in Spanish. In my third year here, the kind of exploration that a liberal arts college allows you to do, your freedom of picking courses, especially here at Lawrence where you're not bound and restrained by a lot of requirements, it let me look into other fields and other disciplines, and the one of urban studies fascinated me. So I changed my major, taking a core curriculum of sociology courses and economics courses that will add up to an urban studies major. The urban studies major that I started to pursue concentrated mainly on American cities. In order that I could get a better understanding of population trends, I thought I should expand it to an international level. So I'm doing a study on the Soviet system of cities, the way that their urban centers have grown, and the impact that economic and political structures play on the growth of urban centers. I'm doing this in coordination with Mr. Martin and Mr. Hiddle, also with a little help from Mr. Schwartz from the Econ Department.
Each student finds the Lawrence that suits him. Together, students bring the qualities of excitement and intensity to their study and activities. And together, they and the faculty expand the reach of the university. Some students search for their interests and find them. Others know theirs and pursue them. The atmosphere encourages both. Students do high-quality work in special fields, but always with the consciousness that, for instance, modern biology and RNA synthesis raise difficult ethical questions, or that the history of Russian cities may help us unravel an understanding of American urban difficulties. So students lay the foundations for careers as scientists, urban planners, doctors, teachers, journalists, lawyers, government and business executives, and in many other fields. They do it in two ways, by acquiring the broad knowledge necessary to go on in these fields, and also by learning to use their minds critically and to relish new challenges.